Hello, friends. Welcome or welcome back. I cannot believe I am already talking about yet another YouTuber who is a fully grown adult behaving poorly with minors. Right off the get-go, I'd love to put forth a trigger warning / content warning for grooming and stuff in that realm. If that's something that's going to trigger you and ruin your day / week, I will see you next time. Alright, so first and foremost, I'm not addressing Anna herself in this video. This video isn't really for her. I just have a lot of feelings, okay? But no, mostly what I'm addressing is the concept in general of adults engaging in inappropriate behavior with underage kids, bottom line, minors. All of this is alleged information. I am not trying to get sued. I don't really know anything. A lot of it was a surprise to me because I haven't really followed her for a while, except for on Twitter, which is weird. Anyway, my point is you can look into this yourself on Twitter and TikTok. I think there's a TikTok talking about it. If you don't know what's going on and you don't care, I won't be offended if you click off. Anyway, I used to consume a lot of Anna Campbell's content. I know her from her YouTube videos before she did the trash thing with Tana Mojo. I was subscribed to her channel when she was still talking about mental health and, quite frankly, her drug use. I found it fascinating and I identified with her on a mental health level. Now we're here. People watching, don't worry, I haven't done drugs before other than weed. I've had the opportunity to, but I couldn't have done it if I tried. Anyway, I used to really enjoy her videos, and I was really stoked when she followed me back on a couple of platforms. I was like, oh wow, we're mutuals, that's so fun. And then I started to not really vibe with her as much, so I unfollowed her on Instagram. I don't remember exactly when that happened. It doesn't matter. Anyway, I think I might just be subconsciously trying to distance myself from her because of the allegations involved, but I don't know the situation. I don't know what's going on. All I know is what I've seen online, and anyway, we'll get there. There's a whole video ahead of us. I have notes. Anyway, I was really jazzed for a while that she followed me, and then I stopped really caring. You know how you go in and out? Like, I had a whole thing with Jenna Marbles for a while, and then she fell off my radar, and then she started doing whatever she wanted, and I started to like her again, and you know, interests, they come and go, but student debt is forever. Anyway, allegedly, she was involved in a number of group chats with fans of hers, and allegedly, she was well aware of the fact that many of the fans of hers in this group chat were underage. Allegedly, she spoke about very personal and very sexual things within these group chats. I've seen some screenshots, and none of the responses that were given in the screenshots that I saw were any kind of indication that this was being well received. It was more like, haha, awkward laughter. My dog just made a sound and scared the shit out of me. Did you just see my soul leave my body there? It sounded like another human sniffling, and that's not a thing that was happening, because there's not another human here. Anyway, as I was saying, allegedly she spoke of very personal and sexual experiences, dreams, etc., in these group chats with people she knew to be underage. And what compelled me to make this video in the first place was my first thought upon receiving that information. I don't think I've even processed it yet. If you're new here, welcome. People did stuff to me when I was a kid that people shouldn't do to other people. Anyway, let's move on. Right, the whole thing that drove me to make this video, sorry, I had to scan my notes. That's why I took notes. Is because no matter what the intentions were behind those conversations and alleged photos, no matter what the intentions were, it's wrong. It is inappropriate. It is not okay. That is a boundary that how do you not see it? Anyway, I had an Anna Campbell video pop up on my feed today, And I was like, oh, what did she do now? Because it was, I can't remember the exact title, but it was like, oh, my explanation about the allegations of whatever. I clicked on it and I didn't watch the whole thing. I don't remember how far I got into it, but I stopped after she explained the thing where she kissed a fan on the lips. I need to stop playing with stuff. It's making noise. I don't know if the mic's picking it up. Anyway, she, in this video, started talking about a bunch of stuff that I just told you about, but it was news to me at the time, so I, as the video was playing, I was looking up on Twitter, you know, looked up her username, and it didn't exist anymore. And that's actually what made me think, whoa, what's going on? And the way, this isn't part of my notes, but it just occurred to me, the way she was very clinical in her explanation slash apology, whatever it is, doesn't sit right with me. It was very definition based, which feels very covering my ass-y to me, you know? I super digress. Let's get out of here. But I stopped watching after she said that, you know, oh, at the time I didn't see what was wrong with kissing this underage... This isn't the brush I thought I had in my hand. I didn't see what was wrong with kissing this underage fan. And it wasn't just me doing it. There was another fully grown adult involved as well who responded, shall I say, much better and much more appropriately, in my humble opinion. Anyway, she didn't see anything wrong with it at the time because it wasn't sexual. I believe I already mentioned this once in this video, but no matter what your intentions are, that is inappropriate. That's not behavior. It's inappropriate behavior. I'm stumbling over my words trying to put eyebrows on. These two aren't even related. Or maybe they're a little too related. I can't tell yet. Oh, whatever with my eyebrows. Let's continue with the video, geez. No matter what your intentions were, you engaged in super inappropriate activity with a minor who happened to be a fan of yours, which created a super uneven power dynamic, which is not okay, which you were old enough to know at that point in time. And that's what yikes'd me out, personally, the most. That's what kind of made me jump ship a little. Clicked off the video, bye. It doesn't matter that the girl was asking. She is a girl, and you are a woman. It doesn't matter that she was asking. You are the adult. Her handle on the internet is Anna Taught You, and let me tell you what Anna taught me. She taught me that it is very important to not interact with your underage fans if you lack the capacity to understand why kissing them on their literal lips is wrong. She also taught me it's important to not interact with your underage fans if you lack the capacity to understand why it is inappropriate to talk to them about your sex life. It is never the minor's responsibility to tell you, the adult, that they are uncomfortable. It is the responsibility of the grown adult with a background in psychology to understand that sending suggestive messages and photos, allegedly, to a group that you know to contain underage people who are fans of you, it's your job to understand for them that it's not okay. It's your job to not put them in that situation to begin with, or to nip it in the bud, as they say. It's your responsibility to tell them no. You are the adult. Something my mom said to me a lot when I was a kid, and it just took me back. I'm the adult, you're the child. No kidding. That's why you're supposed to take care of me. But that's not what this video is about. It's okay. Oh, funny. It's kind of relevant to my next point. In my notes, I wrote down that I'm an adult survivor of childhood bullshit from days past. So I'm personally not afraid to put this out there on behalf of anybody who has received unsolicited messages or photos, or anyone who asked this of an adult who should have known better, and unfortunately, years later, are now processing the fact, but the truth of what happened. It doesn't matter what Anna's intentions were. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Okay, how do I say, hang on, let me put on some mascara and then I'll tell you a stupid metaphor. The vegans aren't gonna like it. Okay, so the first place my mind goes to is that when you cut the head off of a chicken as a farmer or whatever, your intention is to feed your family. That doesn't mean you didn't just kill a chicken. Like, for example, it's somebody else's chicken. It's a chicken that you're not supposed to have access to in that capacity, okay? And then you cut its head off and everybody's like, dude, not cool. You're not supposed to have access to that in that capacity. Why did you just do that? You know that isn't a thing. And you were like, but I'm just like, whatever. It hopped up on the chopping block and I have a family to feed. This is getting out of hand, but it is never the child's responsibility to set the boundaries. It is the adult's responsibility to enforce those boundaries and make sure that the underage person in question stays safe. An adult who engages a minor in conversation that makes them uncomfortable is the one doing something wrong. It is not the teenager's fault for reaching out to somebody that they're a fan of. I'm wildly passionate about this all of a sudden. I honestly don't even care if these 14-year-old girls, I think one of them was even 12, allegedly. Anyway, if these young girls were begging on their hands and knees, please, Anna, tell us about your sex life. They are minors and you are an adult. That is a boundary that should not be crossed, and it is not their doing. She allegedly disclosed a lot of information that, for me, is on, like, best friend tier level, like, very personal information, very sexual information, and to me, that's not something that you discuss in a group of your fans, especially when, you know, with these circumstances, some of them are underage. That's just not something that you talk about there, and you are not... Some people might disagree with me here, but you're not friends. It's a parasocial relationship. Being sexualized by an adult is never your fault. I think that's ultimately all I really wanted to say in this video. I'm not addressing Anna. I'm not even really talking about what's going on, ultimately. I just would like anyone out there who... I'm not even really addressing anybody in the situation directly at all. The person I'm addressing is whoever holds on to any amount of guilt about what happened to you when you weren't equipped to protect yourself. It was not, never has been, and never will be your fault. Even if you never told anybody in the world about it, that's not a burden that you should have to carry, because it's not something that you did, and it's really unfair, and I'm sorry. Anyway, that's that. My glasses are very dirty. Anyway, I just felt compelled to say something, and if it means something, cool. And if it doesn't, also cool. I think more people need to understand that it doesn't matter what your intention was as an adult in that kind of situation. It's inappropriate. It's inappropriate. Super big yikes. Anyway. That being said, don't forget to be kind to yourself and others today. I'm not a hypocrite. Was this video unkind? Anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon.